Tensors in computer science. Initially, the term tensor was introduced into physics and only later was described mathematically. In its modern meaning, as a generalization of a scalar, vector, and matrix, the word tensor was first introduced by Waldemar Vogt to describe mechanical stresses in his book The Fundamental Physical Properties of Crystals in an Elementary Representation. The concept of a tensor is one of the basic fundamental mathematical concepts. Tensors provide a concise mathematical framework for formulating and solving problems in various fields of physics, mathematics, and computer science, such as data science, machine learning, and deep learning. The concept of a tensor was systematically developed in the period 1886 to 1901 by Italian geometer Gregorio Ricci Curbastro and the Italian mathematician Tullio Levizzi Vita. Attention to the new apparatus, called as tensor analysis, increased significantly in 1915-1916 due to Albert Einstein's theory of general relativity, formulated completely in the language of tensors. Let's look at tensors in general. In natural science, various objects are assigned properties that are common and qualitatively identical for many objects, but quantitatively individual for each object. A separate property is called a physical quantity or simply a quantity. Examples of such physical quantities are volume, mass, density, temperature, work, energy, speed, acceleration, force, pressure, etc. The assignment of numerical values to physical quantities involves arbitrariness due to the choice of a coordinate system. However, the objective relationships existing between quantities don't depend on this subjective ways of description. The tensor calculus is a mathematical tool by which such invariant relations between values of objects are formulated. There are so many different concepts used in physics, so we need to systematize and classify them in some way. From a mathematical point of view, such classification might be provided according to so-called tensor criterion. Since all concepts that describe the quantitative characteristics of physical objects are tensors, but tensors of different orders or ranks. Zero-rank tensors are called scalars. Tensors of the first rank are called vectors. The second rank tensors are matrices. These types of tensors are well known from high school mathematics and physics courses. Tensor in computer science. What is the meaning of tensor in computer science, especially data science, machine learning, and deep learning? Simply put, a tensor in computer science is just a bunch of data represented in a certain way. Let's take a look at simple examples that will give us intuition into tensors in computer science. So, let's imagine a ball of some mass. When we want to write its value into computer's memory, we should use a variable or constant, which for example we will write as m equals 5. This entity, by analogy with physics and mathematics, is called a scalar or tensor of rank 0. In order to mathematically represent the location of an object and write this information into a computer, we should use a coordinate system, for example, with axes x, y, and z. As a result, the ball's position will be represented as an array or list of coordinates. Then we assign it some variable. So we have our variable equals square brackets x, y, and z. This form of data recording is called a vector or tensor of the first rank, since in order to access any value in the list, we need one index. For representing movement of the ball, we may write the coordinates of each ball position as a separate line. The resulting matrix, or two-dimensional array, can be considered as a tensor of the second rank. Since to access any value from the matrix, we already need to use two indices. What if we want to keep track of two objects? In this case, it will be convenient to combine two matrices, one for each object, into one entity. The resulting array is called the tensor of third rank. Why? As you probably already guessed, because in order to access any value from such a tensor, three indices must be specified. By analogy, tensors of higher ranks can be created as well, although difficult to imagine them, since our imagination is limited to three-dimensional space. Therefore, tensors in computer science are not as difficult to understand as in physics, although they are still very important and useful in processing of data, especially big data. Tensors are fundamental for machine learning and deep learning, so even Google named its machine learning library as TensorFlow. Thanks for your attention. If you have any questions or thoughts about tensors or science, please put it in comments below.